Situation. In 2013, the agency did a campaign for Lutzer's Archive in exchange for advertising space in the magazine. But how does an agency do a print ad for itself? Put up its logo and its web address? Make a little joke? Or showcase its work? Since this was the issue of Lutzer's Archive dedicated to the Cannes Advertising Festival, and the magazine was going to be distributed for free to all the festival attendees, we decided to do something bigger with our advertising space, and a simple print ad became a self-promo campaign with a simple goal, publicity. The campaign consisted of a print ad, a mobile web page, a Facebook page, a SlideShare presentation, and a utopian social cause. Speaking out on behalf of all the small independent agencies that are struggling to afford the expensive festival submission fees and that end up being spectators of the festival. A copy-based print ad containing a QR code was published in the magazine for all the fancy advertising industry people to see and to react to. You, yes, you, big network agency. We, the tiny independent agencies, have some news for you. Your lion is not as big as you think. Sorry. If you think that that lion of yours, the one you secretly touch over and over again, means that your ad is one of the best in the world, well, you're wrong. Because just one fraction of the world was competing with you, the ones that could afford the entry fee. So what if we tell you that you can get a free lion enlargement by helping the agencies that currently cannot send their work to Cannes because one entry costs them as much as a few months of their copywriter's salary? Beat hundreds, thousands of agencies more than before, and you will be enjoying your new big fat lion in no time, guaranteed. Help us convince the Cannes Festival organizers to introduce a more democratic pricing system, just as they already do with the registration packages. Please, sign our petition at www.enlargeyourlion.org. The more work is sent to Cannes, the bigger your lion will feel. Unless you lose, of course. But you're not afraid of us, are you? The ad contained a QR code that led to a dedicated webpage where people could express their support for the cause and see who's behind it. One could play around. Like the cause, sign the petition, and spread the word by changing one's Facebook cover or profile photos. It wasn't exclusively for advertisers. Anyone supporting true democracy could sign. Result. As expected, the number of those who went public by actually signing the edgy petition wasn't too high, but the publicity it gained was astonishing. Numerous advertising magazines and blog posts appeared, and when put up on a SlideShare, Enlarge Your Lion became the top presentation of the day, getting over 70,000 views in less than 24 hours. We were pretty sure that a regular letter with a list of people who signed the petition to the festival organizers would go unnoticed or be ignored. So we would like to send this case to Cannes as a festival entry, but that's still damn expensive. So we're raising funds for it. If you're with us on this, please support the cause at www.enlargeyourlion.org. Now back to the publicity goal of the campaign. After the campaign, the agency, located in a small country in the upper right corner of Europe, raised its awareness globally. It received several international pitch invitations, World Bank, Skittles, Unilever being among them, did a couple of international campaigns in Canada, the UK, and Ukraine, and quadrupled the number of its international employees. Thanks. We wish you a large lion.